Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjalayammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 1.2 in Fluid Mechanics. We are going to solve problems in the fluid properties. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the fluid properties. Like mass density, specific weight, specific volume, specific gravity, viscosity, compressibility, vapor pressure, surface tension and capillarity. So all the properties were discussed and the equations to calculate all the properties are also presented in the first lecture. And in this lecture, we are going to solve problems from the Anna University question paper. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in fluid properties. Example number one, determine the mass density, specific volume and specific weight of a liquid whose specific gravity is 0.85. And this is from May 2010 question paper. So specific gravity is given 0.85. Density of the liquid equal to specific gravity into density of water. So for the standard fluid for liquid is water. So, density of the liquid equal to rho, specific gravity is 0.85 into 1000, density of water equal to 1000, equal to 850 kilograms per meter cube. And specific volume of the liquid, specific volume equal to 1 by density, so 1 by 850 equal to 1.176 in 10 power minus 3 meter cube per kilogram. And specific weight of the liquid, W equal to rho into G, so 850 into 9.81 equal to 8253.5 newtons per meter cube. The next example, at certain point of in a castor oil, their shear stress is 0.216 newtons per meter square. The elastic gradient is 0.216 second per second. If the mass density of the castor oil is 959.42 kilograms per meter cube, find the kinematic viscosity. And this is from November 2019 question paper. So we are given shear stress equal to 0.216 newtons per meter square. Density of the castor oil is 959.42 kilogram per meter cube. The velocity gradient du by dt equal to 0.216 second to the power minus 1. So the dynamic viscosity of the castor oil mu equal to shear stress divided by the velocity gradient. So shear stress equal to 0.216. Velocity gradient is also 0.216. So the dynamic viscosity is 1 newton second by meter square. And kinematic viscosity, nu equal to mu by rho, dynamic viscosity divided by the density of the fluid. So 1 divided by 959.42 equal to 1.042 in 10 power minus 3, which is equal to multiplying by 10.4, this is 10.42 stokes. So 10 power 4 meter square per second equal to 1 stokes. So nu equal to in meter square per second. Next example from November 2019 question paper, the velocity distribution over a plate is given by u equal to 2 by 3 y minus y square, in which u is the velocity in meters per second at a distance y meters above the plate. Determine the shear stress at y equal to 0 and y equal to 0.15 meter. The dynamic viscosity of the fluid is 8.63 poise. So dynamic viscosity is 8.63 poise equal to 0.863 newton second by meter square, and the velocity distribution is given by 2 by 3 y minus y square. So velocity gradient u equal to 2 by 3 y minus u velocity equal to 2 by 3 y minus y square. So velocity gradient du by dy equal to 2 by 3, differentiating this equation, 2 by 3 minus 2y. Now the velocity gradient du by dy at y equal to 0, so 2 by 3 minus 2 into 0 equal to 0.6667. And the velocity gradient to y equal to 0.15, 2 by 3 minus 2 into 0.15 equal to 0.3667. Now we calculate the shear stress. Shear stress is given by tau equal to mu into du by dy. At the y equal to 0, we substitute tau equal to mu into du by dy at y equal to 0. So 0.863 into 0.667 equal to 0.575 newtons per meter square. And similarly, at y equal to 0.15 meter, shear stress equal to mu into du by dy at y equal to 0.15, which is 0.863 into 0.3667 equal to 0.316 newtons per meter square. Example number 4, The velocity distribution of flow over a plate is parabolic with vertex 30 cm from the plate, where the velocity is 180 cm per second. If the viscosity of the fluid is 0.9 Newton second per meter square, find the velocity gradient and the shear stress at a distance of 0, 15 cm and 30 cm from the plate. This is from November 2019 question paper. And the velocity profile is parabolic with the vertex equal to 30 cm, velocity u equal to 180 meters per second at 30 cm, mu equal to 0.9 Newton second per meter square, y1 equal to 0 cm, y2 equal to 15 cm and y3 equal to 30 cm. Now the parabolic velocity profile u equal to ay square plus by plus c. Now we recite there are three constants a, b, c. We recite three boundary conditions. So the boundary conditions at y equal to 0 on the surface of the plate, the velocity is 0. At y equal to 30, velocity equal to 180 centimeters per second. It is given in the problem. At y equal to 30, the velocity gradient du by dy equal to 0. So velocity, because velocity is constant, so velocity gradient du by dy equal to 0. So using the three boundary conditions, we will calculate what is a, b, c and then the velocity profile. So at y, x equal to 0, y equal to 0, u equal to 0, first boundary condition. So substituting u equal to a y square plus b y plus c. So 0 equal to a into 0 plus b into 0 plus c. So c equal to 0. Using the second boundary, third boundary condition, at x equal to 30, u equal to 180. Second boundary condition, u equal to 180. So 180 equal to a into 30 square plus b into 30. So we take this is equation number 1. And we calculate du by dy, which is 2ay plus b. So at y equal to 30, du by dy equal to 0. So 0 equal to 2a into 30 plus b. So b equal to minus 60 times of a. Now you substitute the second equation in the first equation. So we'll get 180 equal to 900 into a minus 30 into 60 into a. That is equal to minus of 900 into a. So a becomes minus 0.2 and b equal to minus 60 times a equal to minus 60 into minus of 0.2 equal to 12. So the constant a equal to minus 0.2, constant b equal to 12, constant c equal to 0. So the velocity profile u equal to minus 0.2 y square plus 12 y. So this is the velocity profile. Now the usual procedure, we calculate the velocity gradient and the shear stress. So velocity gradient, you take u equal to minus 0.2 y square plus 12 y. So du by dy, differentiating minus 0.4 y plus 12. Now the at y equal to 0 centimeter, du by dy equal to minus 0.4 into 0 plus 12 equal to 12 per second. And y equal to 15 centimeter, du by dy equal to minus 0.4 into 15 plus 12 equal to 6. And y equal to 30 centimeter, du by dy equal to minus 4 into 30 plus 12 equal to 0. Now we calculate the shear stress. Shear stress is given by tau equal to mu into du by dy. So you calculate at y equal to 0, shear stress equal to mu into du by dy. So 0.9 into 12 equal to 10.8 newtons per meter square. At y equal to 15 centimeter, shear stress equal to mu into du by dy. 0.9 into 6 equal to 5.4 newtons per meter square. At y equal to 30, shear stress equal to mu into du by dy, which is 0.9 into 0 equal to 0 newtons per meter square. So these are all the answers to the problem. And example number 5, calculate the dynamic viscosity of the oil, which is used for lubrication between the square plates of size 0.8 meter and 0.4 meter and the inclined plane of inclination 30 degree to the horizontal. The weight of the square plate is 300 Newton and slides down with a uniform velocity of 0.3 meters per second. The thickness of the oil film is 1.5 millimeter and this is from May 2019 question paper. And we write down the given data. Area of the plate 0.8 meter by 0.8 meter. Weight of the plate is 300 Newton. Velocity du equal to 0.3 and distance gap dy equal to 0.15 millimeter. And theta equal to 30 degree. And this is the arrangement. We have an inclined plane. So on which the plate, the blue color plate is sliding with a velocity du equal to 0.3 meters per second. And the gap is filled with oil. And the gap is dy equal to 1.5 millimeter. The weight of the plate is acting vertically downward, which is 300 Newton, and the angle of the inclined plane is 30. And we represent the vector here. So this is the F vector, this force, and W is acting vertically downward. This angle, inclined plane angle is 30 degree, and here the top angle, the angle between F and W is 60 degree. Now we calculate the force due to the weight in the direction of the plane, F equal to W cos 60. So 300 into cos 60 equal to 150 Newton. Then we calculate the shear stress. Shear stress equal to force divided by the area. So 150 divided by area equal to 0.8 into 0.8, which is 234.375 newtons per meter square. So we have the shear stress. Now the shear stress, from the shear stress we calculate the dynamic viscosity. So dynamic viscosity mu equal to shear stress divided by the velocity gradient. So 234.375 divided by 0.3 divided by dy equal to 1.5 into 10 power minus 3. So calculating, this is 1.172 Newton second per meter square, which is also equal to 11.72 poise. So we know, please note it down, what 10 Newton second per meter square equal to 1 poise. So this is to be multiplied by 10. So 1.172 Newton second meter square into 10 equal to 11.72 poise. Next example, example number 6, a plate having an area of 0.6 meter square is sliding down the inclined plane at 30 degree to the horizontal with a velocity of 0.36 meters per second. There is a cushion of fluid 1.8 millimeter thick between the plane and the plate. Find the viscosity of the fluid if the weight of the plate is 280 Newton, and this is from November 2019 question paper. So the area of the plate, given data, area of the plate is 0.6 meter square, velocity du equal to 0.36, dy equal to 1.8 millimeter, and the weight of the plate is 280 Newton. So this is again diagram, the plate, the velocity is 0.36 meters per second and thickness is 1.88 millimeter, the weight of the plate is 280 Newton, and the velocity vector is shown here, angle theta is 30 degree, angle of inclination, so the angle between F and W is 60 degree. Now we calculate the force due to the weight in the direction of the plate. So F equal to W into cos 60, 280 into cos 60 equal to 140 Newton. Then we calculate the shear stress. Shear stress equal to F divided by A, tau equal to S divided by A, 140 divided by 0.6 equal to 233.3 newtons per meter square. Then we calculate the dynamic viscosity of the oil film, mu equal to tau, shear stress tau divided by elastic gradient du by dy. So 233.3 divided by 0.36 divided by 1.8 10 power minus 3. So calculating 1.1665 newtons per meter square or 11.665 poise. So as we said earlier, so 10 Newton second per meter square equal to 1 poise. Next example, example number 7 from November 2012 question paper. Calculate the dynamic viscosity of the oil which is used for lubricating between square plates of size 0.9 meter by 0.9 meter and inclined plane at an angle of 30 degree. The weight of the square plate is 450 Newton and it slides down in the inclined plane with a uniform velocity of 0.3 meters per second. And the thickness of the oil film is 1.5 millimeter. And area of the plate equal to 0.9 meter by 0.9 meter, which is 0.81 meter square. The distance is 1.5 millimeter, velocity is 0.3 meters per second, and the weight of the plate is 450 Newton, and theta inclination is 30 degree. So this is shown in the diagram here. And as in the earlier example, the angle between F and W, the force and the weight of the plate is 60 degree. Now you calculate the force due to the weight in the direction of the plane, F equal to W cos theta, so 450 into cos 60 equal to 225 Newton. And we calculate the shear stress equal to F divided by area, 225 divided by 0.81 equal to 277.78 Newtons per meter square. Then the dynamic viscosity of the oil film, mu equal to shear stress divided by the velocity gradient du by dy. So 277.78 divided by 0.3 divided by 1.5 into 10 power minus 3, which is 1.3889 Newton second by meter square. It is also equal to 13.889 poise. Then we take the example number 8 from May 2009 question paper. The space between two parallel plates 5 millimeter apart is filled with the crude oil of specific gravity 0.9. A force of 2 Newton is required to drag the upper plate at constant velocity of 0.8 meters per second. The lower plate is stationary. The area of the upper plate is 0.09 meter square. Determine dynamic viscosity in Poise and kinematic viscosity in Stokes. So we are given dy equal to 5 millimeter. The gap between the plate is 5 millimeter. Specific gravity is 0.9. Force equal to 2 Newton. Velocity du equal to 0.8 meters per second. And the area of the plate is 0.09 meter square. So we calculate the density of the oil. So we are given specific gravity. Density of the oil equal to specific gravity into density of the water, which is 0.9 into 1000 equal to 900 kilogram per meter cube. Then the shear stress is equal to, shear stress equal to F divided by area. F is 2 Newton divided by area equal to 0.09, which is 22.22 Newtons per meter square. Now, the dynamic viscosity of the oil film, mu equal to shear stress divided by the du by dy, shear velocity gradient. So, 22.22, so du equal to 0.8, dy equal to 5 into 10 power minus 3. So, it is 0.1234 Newton second per meter square, which is 1.234 Poise. Then kinematic viscosity. So, we have kinematic viscosity, nu equal to mu by rho. So, for oil, so 0.1234 divided by 900. So, oil density is 900. So, it is 1.371 10 power minus 4 meter square per second or 1.371 Stokes. So, 10 power 4 meter square per second equal to 1 stroke. That you have to remember, the conversion factor. Example number 9 from May 2009 question paper. Two plates are placed at a distance of 0.15 millimeter apart. The lower plate is fixed while the upper plate having surface area 1 meter square is pulled at 0.3 meters per second. Find the force and the power required to maintain the speed if the fluid separating them is having a viscosity of 1.5 Poise. So, dy, the gap is 0.15 millimeter, area equal to 1 meter square, velocity equal to 0.3 meters per second, and the dynamic viscosity mu equal to 1.5 Poise. So, this is the arrangement. So, du equal to 0.3 and dy equal to 0.15. And the shear stress we calculate. Shear stress equal to mu into du by dy. So, mu equal to 0.15. So, because 1.5 Poise equal to 0.15 Newton second per meter square. So, 0.15 du equal to 0.3 divided by 0.15 10 power minus 3. So, shear stress equal to 300 Newtons per meter square. The force required to maintain the speed. So, force equal to shear stress into area. So, 300 into 1 equal to 300 Newton. And the power required to maintain the speed. So, power equal to force into velocity. So, 300 into 0.3 equal to 90 watts. This is the power required to maintain the speed. Example number 10 from November 2013 question paper. The space between two square flat to parallel plate is filled with oil. Each side of the plate is 600 millimeter. Thickness of the oil film is 12.5 millimeter. Upper plate which moves at 2.5 meters per second required a force of 98.1 Newton to maintain the speed. Determine dynamic viscosity of the oil in Poise, kinematic viscosity of the oil in Stokes if the specific gravity of the oil is 0.95. So, area equal to 0.6 into 0.6 equal to 0.36 meter square. The gap dy equal to 12.5 millimeter, velocity du equal to 2.5 meters per second, force 98.1 Newton, and specific gravity of the oil is 0.95. So, this is the arrangement. We got two plates, upper plate is moving with a velocity of 2.5 meters per second. So, the force record is 98.1 Newton and the gap is 12.5 millimeter. So, here there is a correction, 12.5 only. So, density of the oil is a specific gravity into density of water 0.95 into 900,000 equal to 950 kilograms per meter cube and the shear stress equal to F by A, tau equal to F by A, which is 98.1 divided by 0.36 equal to 272.5 newtons per meter square. And we calculate the dynamic viscosity of the oil film, mu equal to shear stress divided by the velocity gradient. So, the 272.5 divided by du equal to 2.5 divided by 0.0125, which is 1.3625 Newton second by meter square or 13.625 Poise. Then kinematic viscosity of the oil film, nu equal to dynamic viscosity divided by the density of the oil. So 1.3625 divided by 950 equal to 1.514 10 power minus 3 meter square per second, or it is also equal to 15.14 strokes because 10 power 4 meter square per second equal to 1 strokes. Example number 11 from November 2012 question paper. Find the surface tension in a soap bubble of 50 mm diameter when the inside pressure is 3.5 newtons per meter square above the atmospheric pressure. So we are given diameter equal to 50 millimeter and the pressure inside the bubble is 3.5 newtons per meter square. So surface tension of the soap bubble sigma equal to PD by 8. So 3.5 into 0.05 divided by 8 equal to 0.0219 newtons per meter. This is the surface tension, the answer to the problem. Example number 12 from now, May 2019 question paper. Calculate the capillary effect in millimeter in a glass tube of 4 millimeter diameter when immersed in 1 water, 2 mercury. The temperature of the liquid is 20 degrees Celsius and the value of surface tension of water and mercury at 20 degrees Celsius are 0.073575 newton per meter and 0.51 newton per meter respectively. The angle of contact for water is 0 and that of mercury is 130 degrees. Take the density of water as 998 kg per meter cube. So diameter of the tube is 4 millimeter. Capillary is for the water. So density is 998 and surface tension is 0.073575 newtons per meter. So H, the capillary raise H equal to 4 sigma by rho GD. So 4 into 0.073575 divided by rho equal to 998 into 9.81 into 4 into 10 power minus 3 equal to 7.51 10 power minus 3 meter or 7.51 millimeter. And the capillary is for the mercury. Mercury density is 13,600 kilogram per meter cube and surface tension is given as 0.51 and the theta is 130 degree. So the capillary is H equal to 4 sigma cos theta divided by rho GD, which is equal to 4 into 0.51 into cos 130 divided by 13,600 into 9.81 into 4 into 10 power minus 3, which is minus 2.46 into 10 power minus 3 meter or minus 2.46 millimeter. Example number 13, water at 20 degrees Celsius with the surface tension 0.073 newton per meter, specific weight 9.8 kilonewton per meter cube and angle of contact 0 degree rises through a tube due to capillary action. Find the tube diameter required if the capillary rise is less than 1 millimeter. So we take H equal to 1 millimeter, capillary rise equal to 1 millimeter, sigma equal to 0.073 newton meter, specific weight equal to 9.8 kilonewton per meter cube. So tube diameter required. We have capillary rise equation H equal to 4 sigma by rho GD for water. So 4 sigma rho g equal to specific weight. So 4 sigma by w into d. So from this equation d equal to 4 sigma by wh. So 4 into 0.073 divided by 9.8 into 1000 because it is given in kilonewton per meter cube into 1000 into h equal to 1 into 10 power minus 3, which is 0.0298 meter or 2.98 centimeter. So the diameter of the tube is 2.98 centimeter. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering and there is a book in fluid mechanics. If you want to see additional problems, you go through the book fluid mechanics and machinery. And also I will upload the video lectures of all the subject in the YouTube channel. Subscribe the channel and use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to me for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again with another video lecture in the subject fluid mechanics and machines.